We discussed 8th problem, which was triple column, and from all the problems now onwards are triple column cash book. As a result, I am not going to discuss all the problems, or I am not going to put the whole problem on the board. I will be only putting the important transactions and how to treat them, I will be showing through this format. So, be careful, it is not solution for each problem, it is only solution for the difficult transactions of the problem, because the rest being simple, you will be able to do on your own. Now, coming to the, I am taking the 10th problem. So, I am taking the 10th problem and I am taking directly the transaction of 3rd. I am taking the transaction of 3rd. It is issued check to Giri, discount received 50. Issued check to Giri 550, discount received 50. It's a payment. So, therefore, we record this transaction of 3rd on credit side. Just I'm mentioning the 3rd date, since check is issued in bank column 550 and in discount received column 50, and buy is the constant and Giri is the person to whom we are giving the check, hence his name on the credit side in particulars column. Next, I'm dealing with the transaction of 10th. I'm dealing with transaction of 10th, received check from Kalyan, rupees 425, discount allowed 75. Now, in this case, you have checked the date of 17, check the date 17, deposited Kalyan's check in bank. That means the date of receipt of check and its deposit are different. So, you have to deal this in 2 steps. As a result, on 10th, we treat it as cash received from Kalyan. So, I am giving the date 10th. Though it is a check, we should treat it as cash received. Hence, I am recording 425 in cash column, and we are allowing him discount of 75. So, that discount in discount allowed column and name of person Kalyan in particulars column. Now, after this transaction of 10th, on 15th, you have purchased goods from Mansa. Purchased goods from Mansa you have on 15th, but we will not record this transaction because it is a credit transaction. So, credit purchase of goods will be recorded in purchases book. Hence, we are not recording the transaction of 15th. Then moving on to the next, it is deposited Kalyan's check in bank. So, the day you received the check from Kalyan, you treated it as cash. So, now we will treat it like cash deposited into bank. So, whenever cash is deposited into bank, it is a contra entry. So, roughly you remember your journal entry, it will be bank to cash. So, we have to debit bank account. So, on the debit side, enter the amount 425 in bank column. Okay, and what is the reason? Cash is getting deposited here, actually check, but still mention the word cash. And whenever it is a deposit of cash or withdrawal of cash, it's a contra entry. So, indicate C in your LF column and the date being 17th. Now, this also should be recorded on the credit side. So, give the date 17. Here, it is bank to cash. So, cash has to be credited. So, enter the amount of 425 in cash column and the reason is bank. So, give by bank, and as you entered on both the side, it's a contra entry. So, write C in LF column. Now, next transaction I am dealing is the transaction on 23rd. On 23rd, the transaction is, next transaction I will be dealing is that of 20. On 20, the transaction is paid to Akbar by check rupees 350. Discount received 50. It's a payment and that too by check. So, whenever it is a check payment, record it in the bank column. So, on the credit side, I am entering the amount 350 in bank column, and also there is discount received 50 which I am entering in discount received column. Buy is constant which you write in particulars column on credit side, and the person is Akbar. I am writing Akbar's name in particulars column, and the transaction date is 20th. I am entering the date in date column. Now, after this transaction, I am discussing on the transaction which is on 23rd. On 23rd, it is taken cash from bank for office use. It is nothing but you are withdrawing money from the bank and want to use the money for business activities. So, bank is the giver of the money and cash is coming into your hand. So, hence it is a contra entry, because if you remember the journal entries, it is cash to bank. So, cash to bank, it becomes a contra entry. So, I have to debit cash, the amount being 600, I am entering in cash column. And the reason is I am taking out from bank, or bank is the giver. So, I am writing the reason, and since it is a contra entry C, the date being 23. Now, this should be also entered on the credit side, because bank is the giver. So, we have to credit bank account which is on the credit side here. Now, so on credit side, enter 600 in bank column. Why we are crediting bank? Because bank is the giver. So, buy is the constant on the credit side. The reason is cash which the bank is giving to us. So, therefore, we have entered on both the sides. So, it is a contra entry. So, indicate it with C, and the date being 23rd. Now, that is the transaction of 23rd, and next transaction is on 25th, which I am going to discuss now. Received cash from Manasa 650. Received cash from Manasa 650, discount allowed 50, discount allowed 50, it is a receipt of cash, so we have to record it on the debit side. So, I am recording 650 in cash column and 50 rupees in discount allowed column, the person's name in particulars column because she is the giver, Manasa. Now, the transaction date is 25th. Now, next transaction which I am going to discuss is on 29th, is on 29th. Again, it is received check from Bharat, received check from Bharat, discount allowed, and Bharat check sent to bank. It is clearly stated the check is sent to bank on the same day on which you received. So, when it is deposited in the bank or sent to bank on the same day, that is the day on which you receive the check, the treatment is something directly like this. Because it is a check, you are going to record it in the bank column on the receipt side because you received the check. So, it is to be recorded in bank column 700, and discount allowed 100 in discount allowed column, and name of Bharat in particulars column. And the date being 29th.